and in 2017 he won the Editor of the Year award. Please join me once again in giving a very warm welcome to our guests. Photographers, I'll ask you to see so that we can get the session started. Thank you.
Good morning, everybody, and it's a privilege to be here with the one and only Gulzar Sahab and Meghna on a book that's close to his heart, that's close to Meghna, and that's close to me, because we all know Meghna is because he is, but even I am because he is.
Thank you.
In the last few years, I've been privileged to work on a number of his books. And it's just fitting that one of the last books that I worked with him at HarperCollins was called Because He Is. We'll talk about the book, his life, Meghna's memories, and we'll end with a question and answer session. But before we begin, I'd like to ask Meghna to recite that lovely, lovely poem that sets off the tone for the book.
Before you start, let me say thanks to this festival, and thanks to Sanjoy Roy, Namita Gokhale, and the people who have organized it. I must say that it has become the most prestigious literary festival today and the biggest in India. And naturally, the most selected people of Jaipur, the selected people of Rajasthan, who have maintained it with this kind of presence which I see, which is very, very rare. It's not, actually, I'm by default in the central seat here, in the center of it, both of them. She's the author, and she should have been in the center, and even otherwise, it is the youngsters, it is the young generation who has taken up the central seat. And we have seen now 5 minutes back, it is the younger generation who is taking over, and nothing like it, seeing them coming forward. And now they are the leaders and we are the followers. And I feel safe when young generation takes over the hands of my country. I feel very, 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 very assured. Thank you. And with that, we start.
Rest assured, this will be one session where I think we will ignore you a bit and have only Meghna talk.
That's right. I appreciate that.
Meghna, if we can start off with your poem.
First, I'd like to say thank you very much for having me here. It's my first time at JLF. Please excuse me. I'm a little under the weather, so a little congested. I don't normally sound like this. Before I begin, Kamagani, Jaipur. It's a privilege to be here. I've heard so much about the festival from my father. He's been such a frequent participant here. So it is truly an honor and a privilege for me to be here. So thank you for including me. We'll dive right into the book. This is probably the only poem of mine that has been published and probably will be published. So here we go. I know I'm protected because his arms cradle me. I know I'll walk the right path because his little finger leads me. He dabbles in celluloid, so I know I can see. I know I can write because his ink flows in me. I know I can because he believes. I know I am because he is.
Thank you. Thank you.
Gulzarji, it's lucky that Meghna did not venture into film lyrics writing, isn't it? Meghna, to begin with, there's a very interesting phrase you use in the book where you call him a maternal father. You know, can you please elaborate on that? I found that a particularly fascinating phrase to use, a maternal father.
It's ironic and so telling of the person that he is. Today we talk about mothers and fathers breaking the stereotypes and exchanging parental roles with each other. He was doing this many, many years ago. I won't say exactly how much because then you'll know exactly how old I am. But he never differentiated between being a father or a mother. For him, it was about raising the child and whatever that involved. Whether it was teaching me to tie my shoelaces or braiding my hair, learning to braid them at even height because I was a little bit of an OCD and I wanted the plaits to be at the same level and the same thickness. And so we used to have, bouts of crying in the morning because my nanny would never get it right. So he actually learned to do that. My uniform had a sash to teach me how to tie that sash, the tie. All these things, I mean, which are, we know as traditionally not the role of a father, he embraced it completely, and excelled at it.
And despite a career that involved so much being in the public limelight and filmmaking, as we know, is a tough thing, he actually made it a point not to work beyond a certain point so that he could get you back from school. And was that something?
Yes, yeah? I mean, if he was not shooting, if he was not on a shooting floor, his office day would end at 3:30 because okay. That's the time my school broke. And he would always be there to pick me up. He does that even today for his grandson. So there's a fixed time of the day when he will come and he will be with his grandson.
Yeah.
Actually, I may add a little bit because I was not born a father and I was not born a mother. I became a father because of her and I became a mother because of her. Only when she was born, I became a father. So I was not born a father and I learned to be a father. And I also learned to be a mother. And I still claim I'm a very good mother.
Very interesting take that, because there's a portion where you mention him actually saying that, bachche, maa baap ki umar bhi utni hoti hai jitni bachcho ki hoti hai. If you are a three-year-old son, then you are a daughter, then you are a three-year-old father also. Can you just...
He had a very equal approach to parenting. Aksar yeh galti karte hain ki when we are raising our children, hume hamesha lagta hai ki hum unse zyada jante hain. But that's not always true. Because your experience as a parent is only as much as the life of your child. So if your child is 2 years old, you are a two-year-old parent and that's your experience as a parent. And that is the approach with which I think he took on parenting and raising me, and that's been his approach to our relationship as well. It's been very equal, and I think the simplest way I can express it is that he always talked to me. He never talked down at me, which was very, very precious for me.
There's anything that...
No, I hope she does the same to her child.
Does she do that?
To some her child, she should also be on equal with him and not try to tell him, do this.
Vaha, there's a different dynamic at play because there's so much pampering happening from the Nanu that I have to be the strict mother. So there's
we'll come to that. We'll come to that. There's a very interesting thing, it's very typical of Gulzarji's sense of humor. I mentioned it before we go on to the next question, is where... Meghna says, and I'm not going to give out the year again, I was born on 13 December at around 3:30 p.m. And Papi says, I made it in time for the first show, referring to the movie timings in theatres.
Oh, that was the matinee show time.
And you also mentioned that Rakhi ji actually was drifting in and out of consciousness. She came to, and then she was told that it's a baby girl, and she again became unconscious.
Became unconscious again. I think he was in the minority. He and his driver of the time, Pandey, I think, were the only two people in the family who wanted a girl. Everybody else wanted a boy. I'm sure they all feel differently now.
That's right. I was for the girl all the time, and I am for the girl even today. Even this period also, I am for the girl, and I take it as my responsibility that girls are equal or better than boys.
One of the fascinating aspects is, you know, his sense of involvement in every aspect of a childhood. There are a couple of stories there, you know, like the Cinderella book story, like you loved Cinderella, and he actually made it a point to, and you know, there was this baby book that he filled every year with something. Can you talk about that? You know, it's not, you know, in the regular course of events that run our life, we tend to kind of miss out on all of that. And despite his career in cinema, he actually made it a point to keep a baby book which he kept updating every year.
So updated till I think I was 15 or 17 or something, right up to she has introduced me to her boyfriend. It's as that updated, the baby book.
So, yeah.
So, no, he's always been extremely, he's also very sentimental and emotional by nature. So, that I think the impulse of preserving a memory, of keeping it safe and keeping it for posterity comes from the fact that he is a very sentimental and emotional person by nature. I think that's a large part of it. With Cinderella, he had always inculcated in me this habit of going to a bookstore and picking out books. And somehow my favorite book of the time was Cinderella, and he took it upon himself every time he would travel. Airport bookshops are actually his favorite place. When he's traveling, he makes it a point, even those years, so many years ago, to get to the airport 2 hours before the flight, just so that he could spend time in the bookstore. He would pick up every kind edition version of Cinderella that he would find for me. And it eventually turned out that I had close to 22 different kinds of books on Cinderella. Yeah, it's just that nurturing, that love for books started very early with me.
Yeah. Guzaji, do you still look for Cinderella?
I look for those books of Legos and...
Now it's Lego and Star Wars.
Which are the choice of my grandson now. So I look for that because I have that collection of Cinderella for her, and if I come across a new edition of Cinderella, only that book, then that I will pick up and bring it for her, because she is still the same little Boski for me. She has not grown up to Meghna. So, again, I remember one nice incident which I think she has mentioned in the book somewhere. I used to take her around on my visit to any bookshop for that matter. So, and it becomes a child's habit also, play with the books and picking up the books and seeing through the pictures and seeing through the illustrations, and then feels very proud, a small child reading the sentence and spelling puri samajh mein aa gayi, and very child will bring it. I wanted this book only because he could read those lines and the name of the stories. And I remember one shop at Linking Road where I used to go quite often, and that gentleman who was the owner, his name happened to be Javed Sahab. So I was looking for the books, and she was looking for her books at that time. And Javed Sahab comes to me and tells me, "Guldar Sahab, I've not come across any child who comes and asks me for a book by the author's name." she asked, "Do you have any book of Hans Christian Andersen? Show me." I think that was quite, and I felt very happy and very proud. I still feel proud about you and about your choice of books and subjects. But that was one more moment which I always stored with me. यहाँ पे कुछ बहुत लोगों का झगड़ा हो रहा है शायद, है ना? अच्छा, वो पीछे है. अच्छा, हाँ, कुछ ऐसा लग रहा था कोई पार्टी के निजाम में कोई गड़बड़ है.
चलिए. One of the things that you just mentioned was she still remains Bosky, and we'll come to that with two aspects. One, I'm not sure many people know why you named her Bosky. There's a reason. There's, you know, like, what that, there's a meaning of that. Can you talk of that? And at when she was 4 years old, you wrote your first poem for her. A four-line poem for 4 days old. You know, can you please recite that?
Actually, the child mostly are like their children, but she was very silky when I used to pick her up. तो उसे गोद में लेते हुए या बाहों में लेते हुए इतनी वो सिल्की, वो मतलब वो डर रहता था कहीं फिसल नहीं जाए. हालांकि वो कपड़े भी उतने ही सिल्की थे जिनके अंदर इसे लपेटा हुआ रखते थे और देते थे. तो आई कॉल्ड हर बोस्की. इज एन ओल्ड क्लासिक चाइनीज सिल्क. सो आई स्टार्टेड कॉलिंग हर शी इज सिल्की लाइक बोस्की लाइक दैट सिल्क. एंड तो राखी जी डिडंट लाइक दैट नेम. शी सेड नो. ये क्या हुआ? वो कपड़े का नाम कैसे रखेंगे? आई वोंट नेम माय चाइल्ड ऑन बुक. आई सेड बट लड़का नहीं हुआ तो अब तो क्या, तो लड़का होता तो क्या करते? मैं लट्ठा नाम रखता उसका. बिकॉज आई डील इन टेक्सटाइल्स. तो लड़का होता तो उसका लट्ठा रखते. तो लोग बट समहाउ I remember Om Ji once came home, Jeev Prakash, and he said, "What a name! What a beautiful name!" So she finally accepted it because of the pressures of the people's liking. क्योंकि लोगों को वो people में hate होना बड़ा जरूरी होता है ना. तो somewhere, so that's how she accepted this name, and it continues. And I remember my first few lines which I wrote, कि बूंद गिरी है उसकी. बिट्टू रानी बोस्की, बूंद गिरी है वो उसकी, वो उसका दाना मोती है जिसमें बोस्की सोती है. So that was the first poem which I wrote for her when she was born.
So can you imagine having a poem written for you when you were 4 days old? And that must have influenced, that must have seeped into you, because you also started writing very early. And at the age of 7 or 8, I think you wrote a poem when he refused to give you some money. If you could just narrate that incident and then she can recite that poem.
Well, I think wo sare bacche isi tarah karte hain. Lekin you feel nice agar if you have how you have brought up your child. So finally you have to receive it. उसको जिस तरह से आप सिखाएंगे, अगर उसको जिद और लड़ाई करना सिखाना, चीखना सिखाया, तो वो वैसे ही आपको मिलेगा ना वापस. तो इट हैज़ टू कम बैक टू यू. सो इसलिए यू बेटर बी केयरफुल व्हेन यू ब्रिंग अप अ चाइल्ड. तो वन डे शी वाज आस्किंग फॉर मनी. आई डिडंट वांट हर टू एनीथिंग. आई वुड गेट हर व्हाटएवर शी वांट्स. वो लेके दे देते हैं. लेकिन नहीं, उसे स्कूल में कुछ लेना था या कुछ देना था या किसी दूसरे दोस्तों के साथ कुछ. तो आई वॉन्ट मनी, शी वॉन्टेड सम मनी एंड वॉन्टेड मनी. तो मैंने इसे ना तो नहीं की थी, लेकिन मैंने इसे टाल दिया था किसी तरह. और मैं निकल गया वहाँ से. एंड व्हेन आई कम बैक आई फाइंड दैट चिट ऑन माय टेबल वेयर इट वाज रिटन माय फादर इज वेरी कनिंग. आई एम आस्क फॉर मनी एंड ही इज रनिंग. So I knew it has come back to me. Whatever. She did write poetry later on also, and some poems are in the Indo-British anthology.
Absolutely.
There are.
But if you could recite that poem,
Shantanu, really,
please. I think this is a precious memory.
This is the part that belongs to the unmentionables in the book, but okay. I have a father who gives me money. I'd hate him not rather. He loves me as honey. I love my father too. He polishes my shoe. He's sometimes sweet, sometimes funny. But today I want money, so away he's running.
I think that was a lovely point. Oh.
In all this love and involvement, there were also kabhi aapko daantte the? Did he sort of was, you know, there was this thing about you were doing a lot of things. You were learning the sitar and learning karate, and then you wanted to do ballet, and you were doing piano. And there's a very interesting lesson in that piano lesson. That would you like to talk about that?
Yeah. So I don't have a single memory of him ever raising his voice at me. Unhone kabhi nahi daanta hai mujhe. But he was always very stern, and he made it very clear what was important, and a sense of discipline towards your padhai or whatever you're doing is extremely important for him, and there's going to be no slacking in that. I think I was in class 3 or class 4, and it was that one year where I had taken on karate, ballet, piano and something else. So as a child, there was very little time for free play, and I would see padoos ke bache and they would be out playing, and I could hear them screaming and, you know, having fun, and here I was sitting and practicing piano. So I think in a moment of rebellion, I just shut the piano down and I said, I'm not playing, I'm going down. And I think that's the only time in his sternest voice possible, without raising it, he opened it and he said, you will sit here and you will play that piece till you get it right. And that was enough for me to know that, you know, you can't, there are boundaries which you can't push. He is my friend, he is my confidant, but yet, you know, there is a very, very firm line where he can be a parent when he needs to.
And a responsibility is a responsibility.
Yes, your discipline towards whatever you're doing is very important, and because he's lived his life like that and still does till today, his discipline towards his writing, towards getting to his writing table every day from 10 in the morning to 3 in the afternoon, it's because he is like that, that he as a parent instilled that in his child.
No, I do confess, and I agree that I'm of the same age of the child. But at the same time, there is also a responsibility on me. There is one part of me which has to use its own experience and tell the child. I mean, that a child needs that guidance also. And a child would need that. And that also is learning to become a father, when I say it. So one thing which I allowed her to indulge anything, she wanted to paint, and she painted, and she wanted to dance, and she karate or whatever, you know, at that age something fascinates you. Koi bhi cheez fascinate kar jati. Yahan tak mera khayal hai halwai ko dekha hota to shayad wo jalebiyan banana bhi seekhti. Ha na, wo bachchon ka fascination aise hi hota hai. To usme she was, and her teacher also, school teacher also, she sings so well, why don't you let her learn piano? Or because स्कूल में वो पियानो बजाती थी, जेनिफर वॉज हर नेम. तो मैंने पियानो ले दिया, हासिल कर दिया, टी शर्ट रख के दिया सीखना. बट एजुकेशन इज अ मस्ट फॉर यू, हैव टू इंसिस्ट फॉर एजुकेशन. जो कर रहे हैं आप, जो भी करें, वो सीखिए. सीख के आपको छोड़ देना, छोड़ दीजिए, आपकी मर्जी. इट गोज विद योर टेम्परमेंट. एज यू ग्रो, योर इंटरेस्ट कैन चेंज, योर फोकस कैन शिफ्ट. सो when she was learning that, to main wo bahar jaake cricket baad mein khelenge, ball baad mein khelenge, ye this is your time for this, and you have to sit down and practice this, Because when the teacher comes, I don't want you to be a failure there. You have to do that. And I think that discipline has continued. It has continued with myself. I remember in the morning when she would get up, I didn't tell her to learn sitar or learn music or but so that an ambience of the house which you provide, a child will imbibe so many things. Your own behavior toward your servants or toward your relatives or your parents, or that will be imbibed by your child. And I could see that she knew my discipline and she knew my way of working. And in the morning I started learning sitar in those years. I was playing sitar. And so then in the morning when she gets up, my teacher used to come at 4 o'clock. So that when she gets up, she would hear music with her. I don't have to tell her what is music or you should learn music. And I think that went into her and surreli thi, surreli hai, surreli rahegi, inshallah.
As a sort of corollary to this, there was this very touching incident that you mentioned, Meghna, probably the only, and that's something you mentioned having forgotten altogether till he brought it up during the course of your conversation on the book, where he did not sort of believe you on certain aspects. Not that you did not lie to him, you did lie to him about other aspects, but at that particular incident, would you like to talk about that, both of you, you know, like how that trust is important and that trust, you saying the truth and he believing it, a child and a parent having that sort of, would you like to talk about that? And because that gives a very interesting insight. You
know? I mean, for me personally, I feel it is so important for a child to be completely secure and confident in the belief that their parents trust them.
Yeah.
More than anything else, it instills such a sense of responsibility that you never ever want to break that trust. So automatically it becomes a check and balance in its own way. What happened with me was that, and I didn't remember this, we were in the course of conversation of the book, he asked me, do you ever remember me telling you ki aap jhoot bolte? And I actually, you know, kind of went through my mind and I was like, I can't remember a single incident where he has used this phrase with me ki you're lying, aap jhoot bol rahe. I couldn't. And he says, do you know why that happened? And there was this incident which he told me. When I was young, I must have been 5 or 6 years old.
Yeah, bahut choti si thi. Aur kahin wo zid ki driver ke saath aur ye playmate mein wahan pe I was a member of that club, to wahan swimming ke liye. Aur mujhe wahan pe chhod ke uske saath aur nanny saath mein thi aur wahan pe chhod ke aaya ki main baad mein aata hu. थोड़ी देर में तो मैं इससे पहले कि मैं वापस पहुंचूं तो शी हैड गॉन समवेयर एल्स विद द ड्राइवर शी वेंट टू सेंटोर प्रोबब्ली
सो आई वांटेड टू गो टू वन स्विमिंग प्लेस एंड द ड्राइवर मिसअंडरस्टूड एंड टुक मी समवेयर एल्स बट टू कवर अप फॉर हिमसेल्फ ही सेड कि बेबी ने बोला उधर लेके जाने के लिए व्हिच आई हैडंट डन
एक्चुअली उसने झूठ बोला था और कहा कि नहीं बेबी ने कहा था मैंने इनसे पूछा आप निकाल दी मैं नहीं कहा मैंने कहा आप झूठ बोल रहे आई लुक्ड एट हर फेस एंड दैट वन पॉज विच शी टुक से हम कभी झूठ नहीं बोलते दैट फेस हैज स्टक इन माय मेमोरी उसके बाद पूरी जिंदगी में मैंने ये जुमला इस्तेमाल नहीं किया आई न्यू आई हैव मेड अ मिस्टेक एंड आई पुट अ डेंट इन हर पर्सनैलिटी that puts a dent in the personality of your child. So don't, that total trust has to be there. And your child must grow up with that faith and that trust that my parents trust me. Oh, it's very, very important. Such an element, you don't know kahan pe aap wo ek dent de dete hain aur wo phir sari zindagi us shakhsiyat ke saath saath grow karta hai. And I learned that again. I was on the learning side. And I said, this will not happen again. Till date, I know. I've not repeated that sentence.
And yeah, it's one of the most evocative portions of the book, though of course immediately in keeping with the tone of the book, Meghna does say, uske baad maine jhoot bola hai.
It's not like, I mean, you are young, you will lie. When you like a boy, you will not go and tell your father immediately, and you will try to hide your boyfriend. So it's, I did lie, but for me it was very important to know that he trusted me, that sense of confidence was very important.
It is, I knew, but I have that confidence even today. She made her own choice for her husband, and I trusted her, and I knew her choice is right. Whatever, it is the relationship, you come to know it. Wo pata chalta hai, aur she came and told me about it. Aisa nahi, koi chupane wali baat nahi hai. Haan, baki jo कि मैं वहाँ जा रही हूँ या उधर उसके साथ जा रही हूँ या नहीं जा रही हूँ, इट्स अ डिफरेंट थिंग. वो उसको मैं बहाना कह के आई ओवरलुक दैट, ये झूठ नहीं है, ये बहाना है. तो लेकिन आई विद दैट ट्रस्ट आई थिंक वी हैव ट्रेवल्ड अलोंग वेरी वेल टिल टुडे. आई हैव अ कंप्लीट 100% फेथ इन माई डॉटर.
Meghna, one of the toughest acts of writing any biography, let alone about a father who is a father like Gulzar Sahab, is retaining objectivity. How tough was it? You know, were there certain aspects that were out of bounds or something that you thought you couldn't ask? The most difficult aspect of his life that you found difficult to write about, ask about, you know, and retain objectivity about? You know, because that's a fascinating part of writing a biography, the process through which you write one, you get to know the person. You're discovering your father afresh through through the process. So if you could elaborate a bit on that, you know.
I think the biggest thing that helped me was that I mentally didn't take it as a biography. So first of all, the pressure of it being a comprehensive record of his life and times was out. I was very clear that this was about a man that everybody knew, but through the eyes of his daughter. So that was my perspective towards the book. I didn't take it upon me to maintain objectivity, because it is impossible to do it when you're writing on your father. And in fact, I feel that I'm actually proud of the subjectivity which is in the book. There's an emotionality in the book which makes it a more honest writing, and it doesn't feel like it's been censored, self-censored or edited in any way. And so I think that lack of objectivity, I think, is a charm of
Absolutely.
The book. You know, and that was always my objective. Coming to things that were out of bounds, I think it would have been unfair to write a book about a person and then not touch upon subjects which perhaps would have been uncomfortable to me, but they are things that are already out there in public knowledge. It would have been a dishonest work to not touch upon it. For example, my parents' separation. Or his, relationship or association with Meena ji, Meena Kumari ji. It would have been dishonest and immature to not address those topics. The better thing would be to address it with as much honesty and dignity possible. And I really think that we've managed to do that in the book without either glossing over it or undermining it in any way. For me, the most difficult part of this book was discovering his childhood, which I got to know about. No parent sits down and says, "Acha, baitho, ab mere bachpan ke baare mein suno." We don't do that with our children. We are so engrossed in their childhood that as parents, we very rarely share our own with them. So I actually was blessed that I got this opportunity where over several conversations on the book, I got to know about his childhood, and it was very emotional for me because the absence of his mother in his life, is something that he emotionally carries with him till today. And that is something that has made him the mother that he was to me as a father.
Wonderful anecdote he has about coming across somebody and somebody pointing out, "Wo jo aurat hai, wo tumhari mummy jaise dikhti hai," isn't that?
Yeah, so he didn't know what his mother looked like because she passed away when he was very young. And at that time, taking pictures or having photographs was not a very common thing. And he was in the market with a female relative and god mein uthaya hua tha unhe. And she pointed to a lady on the street and said, "Wo aise lagti thi, tumhari maa." And all he remembers is that when that woman smiled, he could see a golden tooth. So in his conscious memory, his mother had a golden tooth. It's things like this which were not easy for me emotionally. His childhood, because it's already in the book, I'm sharing it. My grandfather remarrying after the death of my grandmother, them having a family of his own, and he being like this outsider, which needed to be adjusted within the family, is what he said. And which is why he was sent away to Bombay, and then his years in Bombay, the isolation. I mean, you're all of 16, 17 years old.
Yeah.
These things were difficult. It kind of made me look at my, which is a wrong thing to do, but it made me look at my relatives differently. So that part was difficult for me. Yeah.
We'll come to the next adhyaya of the book in many ways, samay, with time. And you bringing up samay now and reflecting on how he, you know, there's a phrase that Gulzar Sahib uses in the afterwards that he's a bachcha bigadu.
That's a good thing to do, isn't it? अरे बच्चे बिगाड़ने का भी एक मजा एक लुत्फ तो है ना आप कर रहे हैं तो आपकी वाइफ संभाल लेंगे वो ठीक कर लेंगे तो शी बिकम द डिसिप्लिनेरियन और जैसे अंग्रेजी में कहते हैं और आप बच्चे को बिगाड़ने तो मजा है तो जब वो नहीं कर पाते तो फिर मैं आप बिगाड़ते भी हैं और संभालते भी हैं तो दोनों जिम्मेवारियाँ आपकी बट आई एंजॉय स्पॉइलिंग चिल्ड्रन आई लव स्पॉइलिंग चिल्ड्रन
Yeah, I've seen that. I've seen that even with my son, how he spoils him.
No, I
spoiled his son also.
No, I think it's very beautifully come full circle where he's gone right back to his role of raising a child like he raised me.
Yeah.
Only he's Nanu now. The only difference is that when he was pampering me, my mother used to discipline him. And now both my mother and my father pamper my son, and so I'm the one who's left disciplining all of them. But it's a very special relationship that they
share.
That's
what human being is.
Yes.
To bring up a human being's child, it's a fascination. It's living in a universe. It's totally living in a universe.
Gulzar Sahib, because you have recited a poem for her, why don't you read out the poem that you wrote for Samay? Planet tha wo,
you know. Ji, that's again. And that's again another moment of writing for your grandson. But it's an experience that you go through. और वो हर शख्स उसके साथ जुड़ा हुआ है घर का हर आदमी जुड़ा हुआ उसके साथ बच्चों के साथ और छोटा सा प्लैनेट समझा था पैदा हुआ है तो अगर सोलर सिस्टम को देखें जिस तरह से चलता है तो हम सब सूरज के गिर्द घूमते रहते हैं ना तो यू बिकम द फैमिली ऑफ द सन सो इट्स द फैमिली ऑफ द सन तो दिस इज हाउ आई ट्राई टू एक्सप्रेस माई सेल्फ कि छोटा सा प्लैनेट समझा था पैदा हुआ है मेरे सोलर सिस्टम में मेरा नवासा मेरा समय दो ही साल का है और यूं महसूस होता है सूरज वो है और हम सब उसके प्लैनेट्स हैं उसके गिर्द घुमा करते हैं मोह में कैसी ग्रेविटी जैसी ताकत होती है.
Meghna, towards the last section of the conversation, we'd like to touch upon an aspect that both of you have been involved in, and that's the cinematic journey that you have had. I have seen in my discussions with Gulzar Saab that how concerned he has been about your career and how it has shaped up. When I saw your first film, Filhal, and I sort of loved it, and I thought it was way ahead of its time in the addressing surrogacy and all of that. But I felt that this is Gulzar Saab's daughter's film, you know. And then when Talwar comes, and I realize that this is a director who has moved out of the shadow. And I think that's something that Gulzar Saab has also been very proud of. So I'd like you, both of you, to talk about, because I've seen his worry on that count, and I've seen you emerging not only out of his shadow, but emerging as a filmmaker in your own right, independent of everything around, except that he just writes the lyrics and you don't even show him the screenplay for the film.
She doesn't show me even now.
Can you please talk about
that? But in that, let me say a few words before she takes up again. Because it is her session actually. We have not even talked about the book, what she has. But it is her session today. And I must say, as a filmmaker, she has grown very independently. Right from her college, she started writing in Times of India, and she became a regular writer. And then later, for films, her beginning to catch the thread, instead of coming to me, she went to Saeed Mirza, without asking me, without even consulting me. She wanted to tap it and know what it is all about. And she did very well as the chief assistant with Saeed Mirza in the scene. So she had that sort of an experience behind her. She said, I want to do this. And naturally, being the daughter of such a beautiful heroine of the time, of those times, so naturally the offers kept coming. But only thing I said, get into whatever you want to do, but complete your education. Somehow I had that complex with me, since I did not get the support to get a regular education. So I knew how it benefits. So I said, just complete that and whatever you want to. But she, I think, tapped at different places and decided she wanted to be a filmmaker. And then she joined me in Marches, in the post-production, and joined me in the last film also. But when she made her film, Filhal, I felt she has taken a step ahead of our generation at that time and ahead of me. Though parallel cinema had already come in and people were making off subjects like that. But I remember she had said, अगर माँ से बच्चा नहीं हुआ, घर में बच्चा नहीं है, वाइफ ने बच्चा, तो आपकी जितनी कहानियाँ आज तक सिनेमा में बनी है, कोई एक दिखाइए कि जिसमें आपने या तो जी दूसरी ले आओ, या तो बीवी कह देती है, या हस्बैंड खुद ही दूसरी ले आता है, और या कहीं खानदान नहीं चलेगा तो बेटा तुमने नहीं दिया, बेटा तो भाई तुम्हारे वजह से होगा, बेटा होगा या बेटी होगी, लेकिन मर्द हमेशा तुम मुझे एक बेटा ना दे सकी. तो दीज क्लिशेस शी हैड गॉट फेड अप ऑफ इट विद इन हर एंड शी मेड Filhal. एंड आई थॉट दैट वाज अ स्टेप मच अहेड ऑफ अ टाइम. एंड हुआ उसके बाद नेचुरली चल रहे. एंड देन व्हेन शी मेड तलवार Filhal, आई थॉट इफ इट हैड कम टू मी फॉर राइटिंग आई वोंट हैव बीन एबल टू हैंडल इट. ओनली अ वूमन good writer could do it, and she did it, write the whole film herself. And then comes Talwar, and of course I do mention Vishal, who 5-6 saal ke sanyas mein thi नहीं अब मुझे बच्चा पालना है, मुझे बच्चा पालना है, नहीं तो बट विशाल हेल्ड हर हैंड एंड ब्रॉट हर आउट ऑफ दैट. कम ऑन, यू हैव टू मेक फिल्म्स एंड यू हैव टू कैरी ऑन विद दिस, यू कांट स्टॉप इट. एंड ही हेल्प एंड फिलहाल दिस तलवार वॉज मेड on which became a very beautiful film again. Yeah. And I knew the entire story narration of this generation has changed. In our time, there was a plot, which we used to, a story, a plot run. No, but this is taking away writing literature on celluloid. That was the big thing. And that is what this generation is now doing.
Yeah.
That when I say it is this generation, and I'm not talking in fallacy that she has moved ahead of me, much ahead of me. It is the whole generation which has moved ahead of us. And that is what is to be admired and looked upon that way. And that's what I feel. And even while writing this book, I think she didn't look up like that, ke bade bada aadmi hai, bada mashhoor aadmi hai.
Absolutely.
In the entire book, she hasn't mentioned that at all. And I'm happy that she looked at me like a normal person, like a normal father. And she wrote this. And the rest of the story about film, she can take it up and say it.
Meghna, just a bit about, you know, the influences and how difficult it was, because Talwar and Razi are probably benchmarks that you have set in contemporary filmmaking in many ways. Like he did in his time with his middle of the road cinema, you have taken that a step further. So what influences and how difficult it was, a little bit of that, and then we'll come to, you know, your biggest prize for Talwar, which is his poem. We'll end the session on that note.
I think the intent to always do something with a more realistic sensibility, particularly because of my upbringing, my personality, which was a lot like his, and then watching the films that he made, I think that bent to do slightly more realistic, more sensible cinema was always there, which didn't make the journey easy, because the appetite for those kind of films is very recent. So the first 15 years of my career were very difficult, and I think it was more difficult on him and on my mother than me, because both have been so successful in their own right within the same industry, and you want your child to succeed, if not you know, become more successful than you, and that was not happening, and I was not asking them for help, and neither would I let them do something to you know, kind of manufacture that success.
Absolutely.
So I think the weight, the disappointment, the frustration bore heavier on them than on me. And fortunately, that changed with Talwar. I think more than the filmmaker in me, it's the stories that I'm now telling, which are making me the filmmaker that I am. Uh-huh. Yes, my craft has hopefully improved, but I think I will give it to the stories that I'm now choosing to tell, which make me the filmmaker.
More than fiction, you are addressing real life stories. And, you know,
I really believe that true life is possibly the strongest source of stories that we have. And I think they're far more engaging and far more connected to our society, because they're immediate. That connect is very, very immediate. It's not your imagination doesn't come into play to make that connect, which will happen with fiction.
Yeah.
With true life, the connect is immediate. And because authenticity is such a challenge, it makes me work much harder to keep that authenticity on film. And so I think that brings out a better filmmaker.
The one that you're making.
Yeah.
The one that you're making now.
I think it's important that mention, next two films that you are making are absolutely outstanding
again,
subjects,
very,
you know.
So my next film is called Chhapak. It's on acid violence, and I'm using the life of acid fighter Lakshmi Agarwal, as a lens to tell a story on the larger issue of acid violence in our country. And I'm grateful and fortunate that Deepika Padukone has accepted to be a part of this film. And I really, really hope that we'll work very hard to tell this story, and I really hope that you all like what you see when it comes out. But coming back to, you know, the change in my trajectory as a filmmaker, I think when my film succeeded, particularly with Razi and the numbers that it did, for me, I started hearing the word tasalli in the household a lot. Papa would say it and mummy would say it, and for me that was like, okay,
no.
You know, that was for me the biggest gratifying thing. Yeah. It was, yes, the audience appreciation, the box office, critic ratings, all of that makes a difference, but when your parents are now finally at ease and their worry is now not over, it'll never be over, but it's significantly reduced. Yes. Then you can now carry on and go and do your work without any pressure.
Yeah, on that note, we'll just open the question. But Gulzar Saab, because she does mention that the greatest, despite all the success, the greatest reward was that particular poem that you wrote after the success she achieved. If you just could recite that poem and then we open.
Ye to meri guzarish bhi hai.
Yeah, that is even Meghna's desire, not just my own.
As usual, this was also a very personal poem of mine.
It but remains unpublished. It's only in
it
this
It is
book.
Unpublished. It is only kitab mein. In dono ne milke kuch advantage liya. Ki ye ghar ke bhedi lanka dhave. To suna hai aapne. To Shantanu, kyunki inke saath kaam kar rahe the. Aur, Meghna ko wo malum tha, aur malum ho gaya. She knows what. ये चुपके से जानती हैं, शी इज अ पिक पॉकेट एक्चुअली. वो लिखते हुए जेब से कहीं ना कहीं से ये निकाल के देख जरूर लेती हैं कर क्या रहे हैं और क्या लिख रहे हैं. तो ये नज्म उसमें किताब में चली गई, विच आई नाउ इट्स नेचुरली पब्लिश्ड नाउ, सो आई कैन शेयर इट विद यू, बट अ वेरी पर्सनल कॉम्प्लीमेंट विच आई वॉन्टेड टू गिव इट टू माई डॉटर वंस अगेन, विच अ कॉम्प्लीमेंट टू दैट ओस की बूंद उसके लिए. Another poem है कि कई बरसों से सीने में रखा था आसमां तय करके मैंने, है ना. आप एक चीज है कोई ये नोट करके इसको कि ये करना है और ये मेमोरी के लिए भी रख देते हैं आप जेब में. तो मैं आई हैड फोल्डेड द स्काई एंड पुट इट इन माय पॉकेट. मुन्नी जी कैन अंडरस्टैंड इट, शी इज देयर, शी हैज मुन्नी कबीर, शी हैज done lots of translation of my poems and songs, and we'll be doing a session tomorrow. To kai barson se seene mein rakha tha aasmaan tay karke maine, meri umeedon ke nakshe the us par, mere khwabon ke badal the, mere ashkon ka pani tha. There any parents ambition, and these are the emotions that which parents carry when their children are growing up. Kai barson se seene mein rakha tha aasmaan tay karke maine, meri umeedon ke nakshe the us par, aur mere khwabon ke badal the, mere ashkon ka pani tha. Main nanni ungliyan beti ki sehlata tha, unko chumta tha, badi hokar ye mera aasmaan kholegi ek din, वो अपनी कहकशां उस पर बिछाएगी. She will spread out her own milky way on that. बड़ी होकर ये मेरा आसमां खोलेगी एक दिन, वो अपनी कहकशां उस पर बिछाएगी. And I kept that in my pocket, now it is exposed. बड़ी होकर मेरी बेटी ने खोला आसमां और उंगलियों से नाम अपना लिख के रोशन कर दिया आसमां मेरा, कई वर्षों से जो तय करके मैंने सीने में रखा हुआ था. बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया. थैंक यू, थैंक यू.
दैट्स व्हाई बिकॉज ही इज एंड दैट्स व्हाई मेघनाज बुक इज सच अ जेम. इट कुड हैव ओनली कम फ्रॉम समबडी लाइक मेघना. We'll have a few questions from the audience if there's time for, but two questions, but these should be questions and not, you know, keep them to the book and to what we have talked about.
Gunjarji, हमें लगता है कि आपसे आपकी सबसे खूबसूरत कविता आपके साथ आपकी बेटी के रूप में है
जी और निश्चित ही अभी ओस की बूंद के रूप में आपने जो कविता प्रस्तुत की वो अद्भुत कविता थी लेकिन क्या आपको लगता है कि आपने इनसे भी खूबसूरत कोई कविता लिखी है और यदि हाँ तो क्या
जी वो इन्होंने लिखी है और उस कविता का नाम है समय
So, good morning, everyone. So, my question is basically that I saw the making of Razi. I saw those videos uploaded there, and I saw this small video regarding your shoot in Kashmir. And you said that you had many memories with Gulzar Sahab there. So, could you share any of those memories?
I've spent a large part of my childhood there because before we started going to Switzerland, all films were shot in Kashmir. So my father's films, my mother's films, and inevitably I would be in Kashmir. I have memories of being with him on the sets of Andhi and on the sets of Mausam also. My mother's films, Kasme Vaade and Kabhi Kabhi I Was Not Born Yet. So for me, it was very familiar and yet life was coming a full circle because here I was as a child on sets of their films in Kashmir and now I was going to Kashmir and the set would be mine and I would be directing and then my son came to visit me. So it was very special.
Thank you. On that note, we'll end it. Just one small incident as, you know, we have diverged a lot between Meghna and I about Gulzar Sahab that Gulzar Sahab didn't know was going into the book. There's one memory I have. Gulzar Sahab, when we started work on the book, had warned me ki Meghna ne isse pehle ek baar jab kitab hui thi, tab wo इतनी नाखुश थी कि वो जाके पब्लिशर के साथ बैठ गई थी और सो मुझे बहुत डर था इस किताब में भी वही होने वाला है बट थैंकफुली दैट डिडंट हैपन शी लाइक्ड इट इनफ फ्रॉम द डिस्टेंस टू सॉर्ट ऑफ थैंक यू सो मच
एंड कम आउट इट हैज कम आउट वेरी वेल एंड व्हाइल यू वर डूइंग इट आई एम श्योर यू नो दैट यू हैड ऑल द फैसिलिटीज ऑफ हार्पर कॉलिंस हु हैव पब्लिश्ड दिस बुक
एब्सोल्युटली थैंक यू
प्लीज store, and we invite you to take your books for signing and any questions you might have missed out on asking to the book signing area. Thank you. This session was proudly presented by Red FM. So in 15 minutes, here at the Next at Front Lawn, we'll be going into Beyond the Female Eunuch. That's with Germaine Greer in conversation with Bea Rowlett. That session is part of the Women Uninterrupted series, and it will start here at the Next at Front Lawn at 12:30.